last quartet of the afternoon. I'm going to be speaking a little bit about what was previously mentioned. So Mozart and Haydn were very, very good friends, and so much so that Mozart dedicated a quartet to Haydn, actually. And with the quartet came a written dedication. A father who had resolved to send his children out into the great world, here they are, these six children of mine. May it therefore please you to receive them kindly and to be their father. From this moment, I resign to you all my rights in them, your most sincere friend, W.A. Mozart.
This quartet has a funny nickname. It's called the Frog Quartet. And this is because of the last movement, which has a very unusual motif. And it's passed through all the instruments. And I may just play it for you so you know what it sounds like. And I hope you will find it as funny as we find it. So this will be happening all throughout the last moment.
As you all may have noticed, the first violin in all of these quartets really kind of takes the show with a bunch of notes and you know, a lot of virtuosic material. But behind the scenes, us cellists really get to kind of drive the quartet forward. And thank you. And Haydn gave the king lots of chances to kind of take control and be the conductor of the group. In the first movement, from measure three, actually, the cello gets to set the tempo. It sounds like this. And in the second movement, the cello has these 30-second notes, which kind of move the movement forward.
So we're almost finished playing the Haydn Opus 50 quartets, and what did Haydn write after that? Well, his next big project was going to London, and he wrote the 12 London symphonies in 1791. He had been trying to get to London for a while, but he couldn't leave his work until the person he was working for died, and then he could get to London. I would like to give a huge thank you. We all would like to give a huge thank yous to Mr. Cooper Smith and Mr. Tenenbaum for helping create this project, and yeah. And I know all of the groups have learned an incredible amount about not only our individual quartets that we've been working on, but also the quartets as a whole and learning about Haydn and his life. Also, we want to thank you for coming and sharing this experience with us, because we wouldn't be playing for, it's different playing for each other than it is for an audience who can appreciate and learn with us. So thank you for coming with us on this journey.
Thank you.
Thank you.